Welcome to Strawberry Signal, a brand new weekly news channel focused exclusively on Indian AI. I'm Caleb Friesen, and if you want to learn more about why I started Strawberry Signal, then stick around until the end of the video. But for now, let's dive straight into the news. Sarvam just launched Bulbul V2, a text-to-speech model that supports 10 Indian languages plus English, and just give this a listen. It's incredible.
Sarvam aapke liye laya hai awaza jo parat diya lagan. যে ওরকি সে বার্তা বিদেশে নুহে নূর সদবেদম সরিয়ান উচ্চরিপুগুলোড দশটি ভারতীয় ভাষায় আন্তে কাদু মিঞ্চিন বেগদ প্রত্যুত্তরগুলিকে ওগ্গিকൊള്ളി স্কেলিনായി നിർമ്മിക്കപ്പെട്ടതാണ് ভারত মাটেনো ভাব.
I don't know if you caught the text on that last slide, but they're pricing this for India. One of the more popular text-to-speech providers out there is ElevenLabs, but it's pretty expensive at $22 a month. That's about 1,800 rupees, and that's after your first month, and that only gets you 200 minutes of audio. That's about 200,000 characters. And remember, that's not necessarily usable audio because oftentimes audio needs to be regenerated. It almost never comes out perfectly on the first try, whereas Bulbul V2 will cost 15 rupees per 10,000 characters compared to 11 Labs, which charges about 85 rupees per 10,000 characters. And they really are positioning themselves as an 11 Labs alternative for Indian users. You can train the model with your voice the same way you can with 11 Labs. And they're offering much better latency too at 0.398 seconds compared to the nearly 1 second latency for 11 Labs. But I think the biggest differentiator here is language support. Currently, 11 Labs only supports Hindi and Tamil, whereas with Bulbul V2, you get 11 languages, including English. Oh, and if you want to test this out for yourself, they're giving away 1,000 rupees in free credits for developers who want to use their API. And there's also a pretty simple demo on their Bulbul V2 website. I'll put a link to it in the pinned comment. And I actually tested this thing out for myself earlier today. So check it out.
I'm just going to start with English here to begin with, see how it turns out. Okay, that was pretty quick.
Welcome to Strawberry Signal, a brand new weekly news channel focusing exclusively on Indian AI. I am Caleb Friesen.
Caleb Friesen, not quite, but it's not an Indian name, so I forgive you, Hitesh. And also, it didn't really say AI properly either. It was like AI. Which is interesting because this is an AI company and they are also talking about how they've specifically trained it on certain phrases or certain characters that might be uncommon in international models, like oftentimes the rupee symbol or how to say rupees as a sort of financial figure. Often it might say it in the wrong part of the sentence or RS or some of these other variations. So anyways, let's try this out in Hindi now and see how it turns out. I don't speak Hindi, so this is Kannada. Why don't we just go ahead with Kannada then? Just let me know if it actually generates the Kannada properly.
Bharatiya AI mele matra kendrikarisuva hocha hosa saptahika suddhi vahini Strawberry Signal ge suswagata. Nanu Caleb Friesen.
I'm not sure if it's just because it's not my language, but it did feel a little bit more gritty and kind of like more tinny too, like a slight roboticness. And I think that's something that I'm noticing about these generations across the board is that they do sound almost like you're hearing someone through the phone, perhaps, rather than it being super clear the way that my audio probably sounds right now. Let's try Hindi and see how that turns out. It's very fast though. Wow, I'm not cutting this video at all. It's just like it's generating these very quickly, much faster than 11 Labs.
Strawberry Signal mein aapka swagat hai. ये एक नया साप्ताहिक न्यूज चैनल है जो विशेष रूप से भारतीय एआई पर केंद्रित है मेरा नाम कैलेब फ्राइसन है
And one other thing that I think it might be nice for them to work on, and maybe it's just because I'm using this one voice, Hitesh. Maybe there's other voices that are more animated. Let's give this one a shot. But it does feel very low energy, and there's also some very large spacing between the different sentences or parts of the sentence. Let's try this out.
Strawberry Signal में आपका स्वागत है ये एक नया साप्ताहिक न्यूज चैनल है
No, it still feels very low energy. Let's try Arya.
जो विशेष रूप
Strawberry Signal में आपका स्वागत है ये एक नया साप्ताहिक न्यूज चैनल है जो
Okay, that feels a lot more high energy. So, yeah, let's just go through all of these because I am curious.
Strawberry Signal में आपका स्वागत है
Yeah, this is lower energy. Manisha, let's see. Come on, Manisha.
Strawberry Signal में आपका स्वागत है ये
That's very friendly sounding. I like that one. अभिलाष
स्ट्रॉबेरी सिग्नल में आपका स्वागत है यह एक नया सा
इट फील्स मोर लाइक अ सॉर्ट ऑफ एन ऑडियो बुक
स्ट्रॉबेरी सिग्नल में आपका स्वागत है
Okay, so to me, it feels like maybe the male voices, at least one of them could use a bit more energy, a bit more animation in the tone. But there are some of the women voices which do have more energy and a little bit more friendliness. So that's interesting to see.
Next up in the Indian AI news, Indic Vault is a brand new data set for fine-tuning Indian AI models, and it was created by Maya Research. In this vault is an open-sourced, under an MIT license, data set providing instruction-tuned question and answer pairs in Hindi, English, and Telugu, and they're planning to also include Marathi and Bengali as well. Now, according to Maya Research, Indic Vault is designed to reflect the way that Indian people actually speak in 2025. The dataset is built around informal conversational language rather than the overly formal phrasing that many of us have come to expect from non-Indian AI labs. The dataset includes over 80,000 question and answer pairs per language, with coverage across 20 everyday domains like finance, health, technology, education, and relationships. And it is important to note that this is entirely synthetic data, most of which was generated using a handful of frontier model APIs guided by a 20-shot prompt. The dataset is available in JSON format and optimized for models ranging from 4 billion to 27 billion parameters. Now, the obvious question to ask here is, how is this dataset different from other open source datasets released by companies like Krutram or Sarvam or AI for Bharat? Well, looking specifically at Krutram and Sarvam here, these datasets are specifically for evaluating and benchmarking Indian AI models. They're not really intended for fine-tuning the way that Indic Vault is. And then looking at AI for Bharat, they've got 60 datasets, including some pretty massive ones like Sangraha and BPCC, but their datasets lack the conversational instruction-style depth that we see from Indic Vault. And so what Maya Research is trying to do here, the TLDR, is to fill a gap that hasn't been addressed by other Indian AI labs, assistant-style QA data that's tuned not just for content, but for tone, structure, and everyday usability here in India. So if that sounds like data that you'd be interested in using for your AI startup or your project, I'll again be including a link to this repo in the pinned comment of this video, just like I will be with pretty much every other thing that I talk about in this video. Next up in the Indian AI news, this will just be a quick one here. Lossfunk, Bharat Chopra's AI lab and residency program, has a new office in Indiranagar, and they do 2 talks per week. So I'll put a link to their Luma in the pinned comment of this video. Also, Bharat recently researched and compiled best practices for using Cursor, which I'm pretty sure many of you have used or you're currently using. So I'll just put this image up. Feel free to pause the video and screenshot it if you want to. Next up, Meta has a favorite Indian AI startup. They recently announced that Bengaluru-based CognitiveLab is the only Indian recipient of their 6-figure non-dilutive 2024 Llama Impact Grant. And this is specifically for one of CognitiveLab's projects called Nayana, a family of models designed to handle text, vision, and speech across 22 languages, 10 of which are Indian. The models in this family include an OCR model, a 2 billion parameter multimodal model intended for edge deployment, and a 7B reasoning model too. Now, this grant is going to help CognitiveLab to expand Nayana's language coverage. They want to support 50 global languages with this project, but just in the near term, their goals are to complete their pre-training pipeline for all 22 supported languages, open source Nayana OCR, publish their synthetic data generation methodology, and also establish partnerships with educational and governmental organizations so that hopefully in the future they can build specialized fine-tuned versions for these sectors. Oh, and it's also worth noting that Nayana actually started at Lossfunk. Next up, this is every Indian AI founder's dream residency. It's a 9-week offline program to build cutting-edge AI agents, apps, and tools in the Himalayas. It's completely free, no equity, no money, no strings attached. And really what this is a focused sprint where a tight-knit group of high agency developers ship AI projects with startup potential. Now, apart from the free stay in Himachal Pradesh, you also get cloud compute and LLM credits to help you build the thing that you're building. And the program is going to be happening from the 22nd of June to the 31st of August, but it's only open to 30 builders. So if this seems interesting, I would recommend signing up yesterday and secure your spot. And the window for applications closes on the 15th of May. So you've only got a couple couple of days. And also, this program is called AI Launchpad 2025. It's happening at Altspace in Dharamshala. And you can find a link to this program in the pinned comment. So that is it for the Indian AI news this week. And a lot of these news items actually came to me through people on WhatsApp or my DMs on X. So feel free to just tag me in a post on X whenever you want, or DM me over there. I would love your inputs on news items to cover in these videos every single week. But now let's answer the question, why Strawberry Signal? And first, the name. It's actually a play on Sony Signal, which is a famous intersection in Bengaluru that I used to live within walking distance of. And you can also see in the image here, the pillars of the Edipura Stonehenge. And for people who aren't from Bengaluru, this is a UNESCO World Heritage Site from prehistory. Why strawberries? Well, if you've been paying attention to AI for a while now, one of the more popular ways to test LLM's capabilities is by asking it how many R's are in the word strawberry. And it got to the point where OpenAI actually had a model that they codenamed strawberry for this very reason. There are also a bunch of users on X who have a strawberry in their username to indicate that they are AI people. And so, yeah, Sony Signal, Strawberry, and also the .com was available. And I think it's kind of like a memorable name that isn't super generic, something like the AI Pulse or something boring. But anyways, most of you probably know me from my other channel, Backstage with Millionaires. And when we started BWM in 2019, the coverage of India's startup ecosystem was very different. This was before the big wave of Indian business podcasts and YouTube channels, and it felt like legacy startup news media just wasn't doing a very good job of making video content about India's startup ecosystem. And so we came in and were basically able to grow from 0 to 1 million subscribers, thanks in part to the lack of competition in that specific category, educational startup-centric video content. And over the last few months, I've started to notice something, that the exact same opportunity exists now for Indian artificial intelligence startups. There just really isn't a lot of coverage or promotion of made in India AI. And I totally understand why. The perception is that India is very behind when it comes to AI. And so media coverage becomes a bit of a chicken and egg situation. Startup news media is waiting for the industry to evolve before they put AI builders on the front page. And it's hard for AI builders to raise capital and succeed without that media coverage. And so what ends up happening is that a lot of AI founders apply for a visa, they buy a plane ticket, and they relocate to SF, where AI adoption is higher, it's easier to get covered by TechCrunch, for example, and capital is more readily available. And also, I feel like just over there, opportunity seems limitless in a way that it probably doesn't here in India. And so if that's you, if you're an AI founder building in the United States, I don't blame you. Nobody's gonna give you an award for staying in India where it's more difficult. And the truth is that India is behind. We haven't had our DeepSeek moment yet. But I want to take you back in time for a second. Let's go back 2 decades when India's startup ecosystem was basically non-existent. And depending on when you were born, you may or may not remember those days, but this was before Flipkart, before Ola, before Zomato and Paytm, and all of these incredibly successful startup companies that fundamentally altered the fabric of India. You know what? That's kind of where we are right now with AI. This is day zero, and the Indian founders that focus on artificial intelligence in 2020 are going to be the Sachin Bansals and Dipinder Goyals of 2045. Right now, you, the unknown middle-class kid from a town that no one's ever heard of, who just showed up in HSR layout with a backpack and a laptop, you have a shot. You have a real shot at winning this game, because the rules of the game haven't even been written yet. And with thousands of crores in government grants and billions of dollars in dry powder that VCs are really just waiting to deploy, there has never been a better time to build AI in India. And so with that said, welcome once again to Strawberry Signal, a place where you can find out what's really going on in Indian AI. The stuff that's happening at offline meetups and in developer WhatsApp groups, and of course on X.